Welcome to the ECQM Fire Sparks. This series of video shorts will introduce FAST Healthcare Interoperability Resources, or FHIRE, an interoperability standard created by the Standards Development Organization Health Level 7, or HL7. This series is presented by the Centers for Medicare and Medicaid Services. It is intended to support healthcare quality leaders, health IT vendors, and measure developers begin to explore the use of FHIRE for quality measurement. We hope this series sparks your interest and engagement in this emerging area of interoperability. In this session, we'll take a closer look at the QI Core Implementation Guide, the preferred data model for expressing clinical quality information. In this session, we assume you are familiar with the current data model used in ECQMs, called the Quality Data Model, or QDM. The Quality Data Model was developed by the US, by the National Quality Forum and CMS. While it was developed with input from multiple stakeholders, it is not technically a national or international standard and does not align with how data is modeled in FHIRE. As vendors and implementers look to improve interoperability with FHIRE, QI Core replaces QDM. QI Core is a FHIRE implementation guide. It builds on FHIRE US Core to enable exchange of clinical data for quality measurement. Let's do a quick comparison of QDM and QI Core. In QDM, we have structures including the QDM category, which equates to what it is, like a laboratory test. The data type, which equates to what happened. Was it ordered or performed? The attribute, which provides more detail about a data type. Is the measure looking for the result of the laboratory test? In QI Core, the categories are replaced by QI Core profiles. Similar to QDM category, each profile defines how a set of data are structured and shared. Example profiles include QI Core Encounter, QI Core Medication, and QI Core Observation. For today, we'll take a closer look at QI Core Encounter. Within each profile, the snapshot table provides further definition of how data within the profile are structured. Let's take a look. On the left-hand side, the folders listed under the encounter are called elements. Elements take the place of both data types and attributes. Some elements help clarify the status of the profile, while others clarify additional information. For example, similar to a data type, the QI Core Encounter profile includes a status element, which defines encounters as planned, arrived, triaged, in progress, on leave, finished, canceled, or completed. The QI Core Encounter profile also has an element for priority, which would enable you to indicate whether you were looking for elective encounters. You'll see the snapshot table has a lot of additional notation and information about each of the elements. We take a deeper dive into defining these features in our What is FHIRE video. Let's talk about mapping QDM to QI Core. While there are some differences between QI Core and QDM, most QDM concepts map directly to QI Core. If, like many measure developers, you are used to writing ECQMs using the QDM, you'll want to check out the QDM to QI Core section of the QI Core Implementation Guide. This section of the implementation guide presents the mapping of each QDM data type to QI Core. Just use the table of contents on the right-hand side to select a QDM data type. We'll select Encounter Performed. You are taken to the Encounter Performed mapping table. You can see that in QI Core, you would use several elements to identify encounters for your measure. Encounter.status to represent encounters that meet your definition of encounter performed. Encounter.type, to represent encounter types such as outpatient visits or hospitalizations using CPT, HCPCS, or SNOMED CT. Encounter.period to determine when the encounter occurred. And perhaps among other things, you'll need encounter.diagnosis.condition if you need to identify encounter-related diagnoses. That's a brief introduction to QI Core and QDM to QI Core mapping. We hope you found this video helpful. For a deeper dive, we recommend viewing the webinar, Authoring ECQMs Using the FHIR Standard, which is available on the ECQI Resource Center and on YouTube. You can find the QI Core Implementation Guide here.